All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome back for the final time this series to the Moon Duck coverage of Mr. Cat Power Gaming versus Sig Trust Best of Three. We are on game number three now, and we have switched up the bands here. But before we get into that, I'm Annie, and I'm being joined once again by Mott Pax. How you doing, man?
I may have been chatting.
Cool.
I was in the Twitch chat. I was typing. I'm here now, though. I'm back.
As I missed you so much.
I know. It was close. That's a faceless void, though.
Yeah.
Like, and there's no drow.
Yeah, look at that drow band coming out. I'm so happy.
Well, what do we got now, then? So what are they going to do with their lives? I guess Signature Trust, you know, hopefully they have some other styles, right? You're just like, oh, God, are you guys, you know, this isn't Na'vi who only picks Wisp and Huskar and wins games at Star Ladder, right? Hey, no, I'm just kidding. Don't hate me, Na'vi fans. It's fine. I'm sure they're going to pick other heroes. Really, I mean, that's the fault of people who aren't banning Io Huskar. Like, honestly, what's your deal?
All right, we still got our first pick, Vengeful Spirit. We're not going to change things up too much. So who's our drow substitute here? Are we going to see the Wisp Huskar?
That could be bad. Could be like a terribly kind of a strategy. Like, Venge terribly, I think, is still very good.
Yeah.
Maybe not up against Faceless Void necessarily, but really, Vengeful Spirit's just so solid against Faceless Void that it's just kind of a no-brainer first pick. And could try and secure yourself one of those last offlaners if you wanted. Like, maybe they like Beastmaster enough that they'd be willing to take it right now. They were spamming a lot of... Yeah. And they were spamming a bunch of Terrorblade, like, last week. So I wouldn't be too surprised if they take that in the second phase if it's left over.
Yeah, I'd be definitely down to see some Terrorblade. I think that's nice and action-packed. Now, Faceless Void, he combos really well with the Phoenix, the Lich, the Witch Doctor... I'm hoping we get to see some neat support duos coming out for the Void.
I wonder, like, Witch Doctor kind of, you know, he's fallen off. But it's a Beastmaster, though. Actually, yeah, Witch Doctor's, like, super the pick here. It's great. It's like, no one really picks him anymore, but he's really good against Beastmaster in lane. And then you also get a combo with a Faceless Void.
Yes.
I'll be very surprised if they didn't pick it. Because I think they'd actually ban it, even though it's just as a support.
Well, they're definitely taking their time here. They've taken their time for that drow pick, too. We tipped into reserve time to make sure the drow was banned out.
But what a Power Gaming like to combo up with this here. So they like the Terrorblade kind of themselves. They have second... Maybe that's what they're considering. Maybe they're just like, hey, you know, we're kind of funny. What if we pick Terrorblade right now? But the only issue is you're up against a Beastmaster who's actually really good against Terrorblade because he can, like, hunt you down using the Hawk and then... kind of like jump on top of him with someone else, or maybe you just go like Necro level 1 into a Blink Dagger and start stalking him that way. So I'd rather just ban it in the second phase, honestly. Other than that, though, they don't play a lot of Faceless Void. Not really their most common thing. They'll run like a Puck with it. They like the Lich duo. Maybe like run that in a dual offlane could be kind of cool.
Well, they're going to go for the Phoenix, which is another one of the heroes that combos really well. Just spray some fire spirits in the pit or in the... Chrono and Sunray and whatnot, and you've got yourself a nice little damage blop. And if you get a couple heroes into that Chrono, then just egg right next to it, time that right, and everyone's stunned for like a zillion years.
Yeah, that's kind of weird. I don't know. I really wonder why they didn't like the Witch Doctor. I guess they're just not fans, but you know, I mean, Phoenix, good hero, you're right. You can combo up, guaranteed Supernova in some ways if you want just like Chrono on top of it. Not typically too much you'll be able to do about it, so.
Yeah, I mean, maybe they wait to see if the Terrorblade's going to be picked up next, or maybe they just wait to pick it up third, because I think Power Gaming, they still are interested in the Witch Doctor, but it might be a little bit too squishy if they're going up against a big guy like Terrorblade.
I think they need, like, a good four-world like Roman to actually pressure the Terrorblade, though.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Who do you want to see, like a Nyx?
Actually, now the more I even start thinking about that, though, like, the Lich actually would have worked really well.
But, until
the Terrorblade comes out, you never really know, so. Yeah, I just get worried about, like, Lich Phoenix support duo, but it's okay. Well, Venge Beastmaster, so. What about like, our mids here, you know? Invoker's still in the pool, works well with both teams already. That could be a really solid... Okay, yeah, ban him out. So they want Invoker.
Well, you know, Power Gaming, they've still got that Batrider at the ready if they want to try that again.
Safe lane Void, Batrider, let's do that. Sounds good.
Oh, Lord. It looked unfortunate and very painful last game for Batrider. But, I mean, we've got a chance to redeem ourselves here. Power Gaming, again, they took game one. You said that you don't think Sig Trust are going to go out without taking at least one game. Do you think they're going to take the whole series?
They're definitely the odds-on favorite. I think it's like 70% or something around there. They're the expected top tier team. So, yeah, I have a lot of faith in them, honestly. I do think they'll take this game. I think Venge Beastmaster is a fantastic start. They work extremely well together in the auras, and they also work very well just as up against like the Faceless Void too.
All right, so Terrorblade banned out, Power Gaming having none of this. They see it, they respond to it. No Terrorblade. What other cores can work really well with Sig right now?
I mean, you just YOLO Luna, right? Like, that's the other play. Kind of run at them, go full out aura strategy if you see the opportunity. It's actually not that bad versus something. Yeah, they're actually eliminating that of the Storm Spirit, too. You know, they're here, they're kind of jumping to the back line, so. Phoenix is really good against like some earlier push too, so that might be kind of why, like, it's really good with the Void obviously, but that could be why they're picking it up despite it kind of falling off a little bit still. And that would actually make, like, if they start sniping out some of these picks from Signature Trust and Power Game, like, wait a second, if they start to come in early, then I would be totally fine with like a Witch Doctor plus Phoenix support duo. Like, that's when they're really at their peak, is that kind of counter initiation play, defending towers, that sort of stuff. I wouldn't mind like an Enchantress or something, but I don't think Signature Trust run that either, so. Just some sort of a, some aura carrying carry, right? The good stuff.
So Phoenix is going to be kind of locked into that, like, Protect Void if he goes for Chronosphere, Sunray, and keep team alive and be ready for eggs. Do you think Power Gaming could get away with something, like, ultra squishy but ultra utility, like a Skywrath Mage?
Maybe? It kind of depends. He's pretty good up against the Beastmaster, right? Taking down the summons, the critters, all that golden experience. That's one thing, man. Beastmaster gives up a bunch in lane, way more than I thought. Doing the math on it the other day, it's like, it's crazy. You give over like 1,000 gold, like, Pylai Dai got something like 1,000 gold across 2 games as a support for just from summons in lane to Shadow Demon because of how good the poison is up against Beastmaster.
Juggernaut. All right, I like this Jug pick.
I mean, that's like the kind of like, uh-oh.
That's this looks familiar. The standard, like, we need a farmer. Let's pick Juggernaut. Like, he's never, I don't think he's ever, like, just a terrible, terrible, not good pick at all.
No, he's the new Gyro. It's, like, exactly what it is. He's, like, anytime, feels pretty safe taking it, works with a bunch of different strategies, can be a little bit of wombo combo, can be a little bit of early push, can even be kind of like a, like, smoking up all the time, initiating on people, and there's your anti-Beastmaster hero.
I like it.
Oracle.
Keeping everyone nice and safe. He screams on them. Just get him out of there. And, well, I think now Power Gaming have the appropriate defense with their Phoenix Oracle. Who's going to be their offense? Who's that position one?
It kind of depends on how they want to play the game. Like, for, what else do they run? They run, like, a lot of kind of, like, Morphling, Terrorblade. Actually, they're very versatile when it comes to their position one. It's kind of interesting. Ben, Morphling, Slark, Lifestealer, Terrorblade, even a safe lane, yeah, or Ursa too. Wow, these guys, they pick a lot of different heroes. I like it. They even ran like a mid-Ursa, it looks like.
Oh, yes.
Interesting, interesting. Probably not so much this game, but kind of cool heroes they're rocking out lately.
Well, we'll see as we are going to go. Fourth pick coming out. They still need, I'm assuming this is going to be a Juggernaut position one. It could be a Juggernaut mid. With that Dazzle, though, that Huskar is feeling neat.
It's so much early push right now, Signature. It's actually disgusting.
Husk, please.
I hope not.
I hope so.
For her, I mean, either team honestly could pick it, really. Like, Signature Trust could just run Jug mid.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Go for the Jug mid, and then pick up the Dazzle Huskar combo in lane. That's dirty.
Yeah, but then they have Oracle Huskar on for Power Gaming, too. Which is, like, just as good with Phoenix.
That's true.
So, Huskar is a real threat here, potentially. I don't think either team have run it recently, so. It doesn't mean it can't just happen, though. And Timber, I love Timber and Faceless Void. Oh, it is so good. Man.
That's going to be a lot of damage and a lot of survivability. But I think Sig right now are slippery enough not to get caught out and all that.
And it's a good Morphling ban, too. That's a similar draft they've run before. And kind of, like, the whole idea would be, like, defense around towers with Phoenix, Faceless Void, and Timber saw, like, TPing in at the last kind of moment to capitalize on it, while Morphling is just split-pushing and farming and eventually becomes some sort of a monster that some, like, Juggernaut just can't deal with until he is, like, an Abyssal Blade or something. So I like that idea there. But something similar, like an AM, honestly, yeah, there you go. It's too scary. It's too spooky when you see Dazzle. No, thank you. But final pick here. So this could be safe or mid lane, theoretically, depending on how they want to run this Timber, what they want to do. But I would guess hard farming safe lane hero.
Yeah, I mean, I think Slark could be phenomenal here, but you want something that does combo well with that Chronosphere so you can do your damage from outside of it. So maybe something range, like, I know you talked about the Gyrocopter being bad, but would it really be terrible here?
I think you need something Alchemist. Better than that, like bigger.
Oh, or what? Safe Lane Alk?
I think they'll run Safe Lane Timbersaw, and it'll just get good levels and get a faster Bloodstone and let the Alchemist do his mid thing.
Yeah, I mean, it could be offlane Timber, mid Alk, Safe Void, but that doesn't really...
I hope not.
Yeah, that doesn't really give everyone what they need.
Yeah, so should be fine. Faceless Void also just needs levels these days. Although, like, the position one's kind of cool, but I think the Safe Lane Timber is just going to be better here.
All right.
Last pick for them.
They've got 5 seconds to decide. They used up all their reserve time. I think they were looking at the Husk, but they're going to go for the Anti-Mage. I love this. It's going to destroy Void in lane.
Yeah, it's interesting. A little bit of a slowdown. Kind of a classic Lakel's style. I mean, he's way more about the Morphling, but it'll be the AM instead.
Would Morphling have been a decent pick here?
They banned it last so that Power Gaming wouldn't have it.
That's...
Yeah, or else, honestly, because I'm sure that's what happened. Lakel's is just thinking, like, man, I want to play Morphling. And he's like, oh shit, they're probably going to pick Morphling. I'll play AM instead. This is one of those kind of cool AM drafts where it's like the other four heroes, not only can they, like, hold the lanes, they can actually, like, push and, like, eliminate a ton of towers and create so much wave presence and pressure coming in from that entire side of Signature Dota, and then gonna rock it with an AM the entire time, farming up into that towards that Battle Fury. He's got great supports in lane. Again, as you said, no pressure because it's just gonna be the Faceless Void. Hopefully it goes, but I wonder if they're gonna put more attention top lane as the Radiant team this time compared to the last game, you know, where like just kind of got ditched. And I wonder if they'll like right from the get go just give him like fly solo or something to try and help out.
That's definitely a possibility. I mean, I'm just so excited to see Anti-Mage versus Void. Do you think they're going to change up the lanes to accommodate for that? Because Anti-Mage can
possibly
just plop him down. If you go for the Dazzle, like aggressive poison touch build, you go with that Anti-Mage mana burn. Suddenly, Void is flimsy as hell. He has no mana for Time Walk, and certainly no mana for Chrono, and he can die over and over again, allowing Anti-Mage to start his scaling much earlier than expected.
And they've actually swapped the offlaner onto the Timbersaw, too. Hopped off. Switching around here.
Oh, look at that little swoop.
I think it got spotted, though.
Oh, yeah, probably, but that was still neat.
Yeah, that was nice. Little play.
Right.
But what are they going to do now?
I don't know.
Assuming...
This is Void safe.
Yeah, I know, they switched heroes. But I don't know what they're expecting. Like, I don't know if they think that it's going to be aggro to try and dodge or something.
I don't know. I'm expecting Anti-Mage to go wherever Void is, because that's just such a smart matchup for him.
Yeah, I think that's what's happening. I think they're trying to like dodge out the Faceless Void away from the AM, and they might just end up sending the Phoenix and the Timbersaw top lane to contest. But like, Faceless Void versus Faceless Void's gonna need help though against the Beastmaster. Oh, jeez. But he started Iron Town, shockingly.
I mean,
sure
does
why.
He just bail out and go straight to the jungle?
Yeah, but I don't know why he is. Like, I guess he's assuming, yeah, because they're assuming it's going to be Oracle down bottom with probably the Timbersaw, and he's like, well, I can't go in that lane, I'll get absolutely nothing done. So instead the Timbersaw comes up top lane because Power know that's what he would do, so he'll go into the jungle straight up in the Iron Talon. So we'll send the Timbersaw and the Phoenix up top. Okay. That means the Oracle doesn't even have to go bottom. He might go there right off just to see. He'll be like, oh, now there's no Beastmaster, and I'll have to run top.
Okay, so just to recap, again, this is going to be game number 3 of a best-of-3 series between Power Gaming and Signature Trust. Winner moves on in the upper bracket of Mr. Cat. Loser drops down, and they will play Mongols next up, starting in just about an hour, or whenever this game finishes. And loser of that series, they're out of the tournament. So we've got some stakes. Winner of this game feels a little bit safe. They're at least moving on to another round of Mr. Cat. Loser has the potential to go home in the next 2 hours.
I have a question for you.
Yes.
And as an admin, as a fellow admin of the tournament.
Yes.
The tournament is called Mr. Cat.
Yes.
And yet the teams only have 2 lives.
I
think about that.
I will hang
didn't
up
think about that, did you?
On the TeamSpeak. I will block you from the server.
Why can't we have a 9 range lower bracket? I mean, I think that just makes sense, honestly. It's really like false advertising at this point. These teams probably had no idea what they were in for.
The battle begins. All right, Phoenix, you can feel it. Cheeky swoop coming in. Oh! No.
I thought he had it.
Yeah, me too. And he's going to take some hits here. He might actually give up his life for this. Magic missile connects. Do they have any sort of anything to catch up to him? I don't think they go this deep.
He's going
to
dive this. He's got blink. He's going to dive it. He's going it.
One, two. Yep, first blood goes the way of Fey Malakel. He's a little bit of trouble here, but nothing he can't tango through. In fact, turning things, burning out the Timbersaw's mana as well. This is going to be a miserable lane for all involved. I think Anti-Mage was a phenomenal pick here.
Are they just not even going to bring the Phoenix up? Man, this is a weird game. So Oracle's mid. So you're just going to sack the Timber instead? Like, it's not like Timber's going to have a better time alone.
Well, it's not like Juggernaut's having a fun time here. Oracle should be able to get a kill or two.
You need a couple levels, but yeah, that just immediate like Fortune's End spam is fine. I think DZ is a slightly better time, because level 1, right? You're like, oh, I need that rune, so I don't have acid yet. And Dabs will just harass the hell out of you. There's the problem, though, is that he didn't get any experience. Oracle was sharing.
Yeah, I mean, if Juggernaut can withstand the storm before he picks up his Omni Slash, before he picks up his decent items and levels, then I think he's going to be doing okay here, because I'm really rooting for Trust this game. I think the Anti-Mage pick on Lakels matches up so nicely with his playstyle. Fantastic counter to the draft. I'm just going to talk this Anti-Mage up a cliff, but hopefully I don't get too disappointed. I don't know if Alchemist is the right pick, just he's so greedy, along with a Timbersaw, along with the Void. I don't know if there's enough creeps in the map to give him what he needs.
I don't think he's like that greedy in some ways, because like he's really good D-push because the acid. And you look at this lineup and you're just like, there's not many mid heroes that actually offer D-push. There's like maybe Invoker, just because he can push like the moment someone leaves tower, he can like take the entire thing, or like Dragonite in some ways. But in terms of just like chilling back and letting a big squad of heroes be annoyed at you, Alex is really good at that. And the fact that Venge is just roaming around trying to deny out some farm here, but It's giving Timbersaw way too much top lane, I feel like. At least the mana burn's now up, but
yep.
I don't think they can kill without Venge.
Poison Touch goes, eats that Iron Branch tree. I mean, there's a blink here if Anti-Mage wants to go deep, but again, Timber Chain will keep him nice and safe. Now, Phoenix
this
joins
really
the picture
good,
again.
Though.
We'll go in, just right-click and Dazzle, trading some hits. They've got the Poison Touch once again if they want to go for it. Dazzle goes in, Poison Touch is the Phoenix. They've got the Icarus Dab. I don't think there's enough tick damage to go in, but look at this mana pool. That's just drained completely dry. Now Phoenix sitting back. The last ticks of Poison Touch will wear off. Going to be alive, but just barely, and not able to re-engage here.
Yeah, Venge's coming in from the tower, though. And that, there's no swoop. That cooldown.
Goodbye, birdie.
This is the thing though. Timbersaw is only level 2. This one you want to apply all that pressure until the second point in reactive armor comes up. Because it's, well, doubles his regen. In fact, a little bit more than that. You get 10 stacks and you get up to 1.2. So life gets so much better.
Alright, let's talk a little bit about the Void down bottom. He's actually farming up extremely well. You mentioned him having a little bit of a tough time against the Beastmaster summons, Dyer's but he's going to be last hit leader. I like the choice of him to go for that Quelling Blade, even though he's just chilling in lane. I think it's definitely working out for him.
Yeah, just grab the Quelling Blade, help you up against the summons is always going to be very important. But just the fact that the Phoenix is like randomly here, no Oracle to like really shut down the Beastmaster. And he kind of pulled like a Darkseer or a
Oh, look
like
at this.
Tidehunter. That's the one.
Timbersaw can't get away. He's got absolutely no mana to Timber Chain with.
Yeah, he's living the sad life. He's got his Mango, though. Killing on that if he really needs it, which was a good decision. And also helping out a lot with his HP regen, so he can just stay here.
Oh, bench
that's the thing, though. Like, you see 2 points? Like, look at this regen. It's 14 passive. This is the same as level 1 with a Tango. How ridiculous it is.
So, Sentry Ward down here doesn't reveal the Observer Ward on the cliff, so... Like, technically, if anyone walked up and blunked to this high ground, they could deward, but Venge just gets free vision.
Oh, yeah. I guess they thought when the Venge came in that she was blocking or something.
That's a bit curious. Now, maybe she gets scouted out here. She's going to be hiding in the trees. There's a Phoenix, a very hungry Phoenix looking for something, and she's going to be scouting him out. All right, she just kind of bumps on into him, goes for the TP out. There's nothing to cancel it. They have to let Venge off with a warning this time.
Bottom lane, no bash. Jacko, give him the harass bash. How's Timber's last hit coming? 13. Okay, not bad.
Yeah, I mean, he's finding some decent levels as well. Level 4.5 compared that to Anti-Mage's 5. Man, these Anti-Mage goggles look pretty stupid.
Yeah, I was thinking that too. They look like, it's like a bad, like, budget Power Rangers movie or something. I don't know. It looks really weird.
It's like, it's 1950s sci-fi. The guy looks like he can't see right. Yeah, like, yeah. Those eye holes are not in the right spot. Alright. Either way.
I don't think Fei Mao's getting enough out of this Venge.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like if you're gonna do something like this, just go for, like, a Bounty Hunter. Like, the utility has been sub-ideal. Like, even a support Ricky, I feel, would have been...
Well, it feels like if he was just top, they could have, like, fully zoned out him first, and... Oh, is that... That was level 6. Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, safely avoid what you're gonna do. Gets Chrono all of a sudden.
Alright, let's just miss all the kills as
yeah,
we
seriously,
look
at top. Yeah, that's... And now watch them not even kill the timber.
Oh, no, they can't. He is so tanky. 3 points from reactive armor. I think he's fine.
And there's no mana left on the bench for, like, the second stun.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
She'll have it soon.
Alright. I think this was a mistake. They could have, like, fully zoned out this timber, and then you have a timber saw, who obviously could not have afforded an iron talon. He would have been stuck here.
Now he's got his level 6. Alright. I need to stop missing these kills. Let's go down bottom.
I'm not
sure.
So,
Void Vanguard build?
Huh.
Alright. Juggernaut. He's got himself an Omni, but no cooldown on that, so just has to sit back and spin and watch Timbersaw walk away completely fine. And that's a big rotation up top. Juggernaut leaves the mid lane, allowing Alchemist to get, or rather, allowing Oracle to go and get some catch up levels while Alchemist farms the jungle. Oracle now going to be almost level 4. Should be up relatively soon. Now, Fei Mao goes in, really wants to get off that missile, but the range is just kind of piss poor at level 1.
The more I think about it, the more I understand what the idea was from Signature Trust, where, like, Fei Mao was supposed to shut down all these stacks for the Alchemist, but unfortunately he didn't. Like, JYC's just been on the ball.
Alright, Beastmaster going in, drops the Prime of War here, but Oracle doing his best to keep himself safe, not going to be successful, but the Magic Missile turning things on around DDZ. This could be a huge kill if they could get
it. He just throws the acid. I need the farm. Does he get them? Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, he gets them!
He'll get a couple
of them. Three of them!
Maybe the skeletons? Oh, look at that! That neutral creep having none of that.
Oh, that's too bad. I didn't get the rest of them. Okay, this just, like, turned around a big part of the game, though. The fact that came in.
Oh, that's
too.
A Chrono, though. Faceless Void going in. Does get the Bastion of the Beastmaster going in for the body blocks on Fei Mao as well. Will he be able to get this? And we are going to have Juggernaut going in, getting the kill on the Phoenix. And now Jacko has to contest. Looking for more here. Jabs temporarily held in place by that Purge. I don't think there's follow-up, though. The Purifying Flames eats up a Fairy Fire and should be able to walk safely back to his high ground.
Okay, alright. That was a good little recovery there by the Faceless Boy getting that kill. I wonder if he actually is... Oh, is he doing the Lincoln's first build?
Oh, that could be lovely.
Who is it that does that?
We could be going back to, like, 6.82 and, like, Battle Fury Void, but...
I hope not. Someone's been running non-stop Faceless Void, safe lane, Lincoln's first, but it actually is a good game for it. It's actually a fantastic game for it, apart from the fact that Omni Slash just cuts right through it. But Mana Void, Roar, solid. That's actually hilarious. I really hope it's that and not the Battle Fury. Although the Battle Fury is fine too, and obviously he has the Quelling Blade, so maybe that's what it'll be. But the Lincoln's first. I think he's won every game that he's done it. The guy who runs it, man, I should really look this up. I feel like it's Shadow, but I'm not sure.
I can't help you there. I haven't seen my share of Lincoln's Voids. I guess I'm missing out.
Yeah, oh, it's something else.
Alright,
and now those old Beastmaster, he's decent. He's getting his way there, right? Close to that int staff, the stick. Really excited to see what Jacko builds now. Jabs, is he gonna get him?
Now Jabs just letting him off with a warning, teasing him a little bit. A couple hits of the sword, but Alchemist should be able to be completely fine, backing off to go get some mana. Does he go for the Radiance right now, or does he not even need that this game?
Alright, it's Shadow. I was right. It's okay.
I'm so
yeah, he'll go Armlet Radiance, I'm sure. Yeah, so that's the play.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Good. Up against this early push, it's going to be so solid. Like, all the summons of the beast map, you get so much value out of Radiance this game. Dyer's as much as I hate Radiance in general, I think it's, like, the item Dyer's that, like, ruins Dota the most. Like, everything that you hate in Dota can pretty much be traced back to Radiance. Like, Naga Siren, Alchemist. It all just comes from Radiance.
I was going to say something, and I'm not going to say anything anymore, so... I'll message
Huskar,
you after
Huskar doesn't come from Radiance, so then maybe that's true. Anyway.
I'll send you a Skype. Okay. Anyway, mid lane, we are going to have Juggernaut going through, picking up some big items for himself. Going to be picking up the recipe for the drums, so going for that stats-based build. We don't see a lot of drums anymore, and, you know, when they are picked up, I think they can get a lot of use out of them.
Yeah, it's so good because it's the group up, too, right? Like, they're just looking for this timing where... Like, the Roar is going to be coming in. The first Necro level is going to be huge. Well, this DD rune is going to be really good at. But this is that D push. Like, Alchemist, good hero.
Radiant's middle tower
I
is
actually really
attack.
Dig this. And Timbersaw is getting all this space up top. And he's like, the thing is, he can't come for fights. He's, like, giving that up. He went for a full 4 points. Like, yeah, not even three was enough. He's like, no. I just will do not ever want to die up here. And that's great. We've seen a lot of people move away from this. But because of the fact that, you know... Yeah, he's heading off a lane, so gotta do what you gotta do. Can't Iron Talon as a Timbersaw. Oh, gets a stack off. Nice. Value plays here. Got his Arcane Boots. He's probably pretty satisfied with his game so far. Much better than the Batrider game.
Yeah, I mean, he didn't die in lane, which was super key. I thought Anti-Mage would do a more effective job zoning him out, but he's persistent. Definitely persistent. Now down bottom, Radiant doing a good job taking away this tower. This is point.
I believe they're
going to
get the first tower. This is ridiculous. Are they actually going to do it?
I mean, with such
like, look at the lineup.
Yeah.
What is this? Is it happening? I mean, he is Chrono, so it's pretty spooky to come down and try and handle this man. I've said spooky a lot today.
Radiant's top right, tower
I'm bringing down
is under attack.
Master. Yeah, they're defending. They have swap. Ooh, this is going to be cute. Jacko? Are you ready?
He's got his fast fingers, we know this. Alright, he goes in, he's able to get the tower. Immediate Chrono Phoenix, that wasn't the play. Goes in for the egg. There is going to be an egg cleanup crew as Jabs is able to go through and easily take that down. And now Omni Slash onto the Oracle. Faceless Void should be able to get away safely. We'll aggro these creeps, but fortunately no poison creeps for himself. But that seemed like if Phoenix hadn't died, if Phoenix had just gone in and egged, like, right away next to the Chrono, then they could have easily had a couple more kills there.
Yeah, he tried to. I think that was supposed to be a swoop egg before Chrono, but obviously he gooped, and look at the punish. My god. This is why I was so shocked. I mean, to their credit, they still got the tower, right? So, I mean, still kind of impressive they ended up getting the first tower, but this lineup is just going to destroy anything that they would like to if you leave them alone. Like, Roshan now opened up here for the Dire side. Despite losing that tower now, they've crushed the Radiant safe lane. It's going to be a lot easier for them to snag up. They can just, like, chill out by their Ancients the whole time. Wait, what? He actually died? Oh my god, he ran to the Oracle!
What?
Missed
that.
He left the Alchemist. Like, Dyer's the two of them are duking out. He just blinked away, and I just, like, left. I was like, he's fine. And JYC's just in the middle of no man's land, kind of planting down the ward, and he's like, oh, yo, a freebie. He's probably laughing his ass off right now.
Alright, Jabs is going in. Tower equals aggroed. They're looking for some push here, and again, with the Beastmaster, they've got some crazy auras. They're looking for some kills. Phoenix is going to be pinged out. Doesn't want to go and take this. Now they are going to go. Wave of Terror commits onto Jacko. He doesn't have Chrono for 40 more seconds, so it's a weak point in the Radiant's timing. If Zygtrust really want to punish this, they can go, but they should just back off nice and safe. Meanwhile, up top, there will be a defense here as Timbersaw is able to go through, pull those creeps, but all his mana is burned because of that. Is
under attack. Yeah, I don't think he's had more than, like, 80 mana in so long. Poor guy. But he's got his Arcane Boots, he's got his Soul Ring. I mean, that's kind of good, right? He doesn't ever really want to be on a giant mana pool. Could end up costing him. Then again, at the same time, like, Mana Void is obviously still a little bit scary. And
oh.
Gonna be the battle of AM versus Alchemist.
We got our Lincoln's Void online.
Good. I like it, this game, actually. So, I mean, he has so much space, but now he just wants to fight. And his Timbersaw's at a point where he can fight with them, though. Like, he's got the point booster, he's got Arcanes, he's got Soul Ring. This is great. He doesn't really need the Bloodstone, like, when it comes to Chrono, right? It's not like you're going to be fighting non-stop.
So big rotation up top. Good. Dazzle, yeah, I think you're, like, the most dead. You know, kill secured.
I don't think that was worth it. I don't think a Chrono's worth that Dazzle kill.
I mean, maybe they thought the anti-mage was like hanging around right behind him, but
Radiant's middle tower is under
attack. That was a very big commit for a dazzle.
They might get both towers now. In fact, they will get both towers now. They want to.
They'll just take Roche instead. Has fallen. Dire's top
and they're gonna trade up
fallen.
Top. There is at least a tower exchange going on. It's not just like Dire, like, okay, thanks for the freedom and get like tier sixes, but Lakel's heading straight.
I mean,
into
they
the
pretty
pit.
Much do though. Like, you're against a Beastmaster Venge lineup and you chrono a solo dazzle at the other side of the map. Like, they know Roche is happening, I'm sure, right now. That's the Radiant team.
I mean, they're grouping up, but just farming up. DDZ is doing pretty well, but our last hit leader is still the Faceless Void. That's pretty surprising to me.
That actually is surprising, because AM has not been participating much. Use the blade now, picks up. Again, another just like early game item. Really capitalizing on the gold he has too, though.
Alright, they're spinning here. They want to go onto the Oracle. That'd be a nice pick if they can get it. They're going to bring the rest of the Radiant squad, though. Juggernaut actually in a world of hurt. He hops into the Omni, but it's only going to delay the inevitable, as he's just going to go and try to get out of here. Will get graved up. Actually getting Purifying Flames up. Will he live through this? Well, thank you, Oracle. He will be able to do so. Now, Primal Roar here on TDZ. There is going to be the Phoenix Sunray to stall things out. They pop in some Vision. Radiant want to make sure they got those wards. Now, they bring in Jacko.
The bash.
Swap back, though. This is going to be fantastic. Oh, they get him locked down. Jabs, he's looking for more. Will he be able to get the kill? They have to hop away from this Phoenix Egg and now fall in from the Timbersaw. They want to go in. They want to get this down. Once again, Oracle helping out with the Purifying Flames here onto the Dazzle as he comes out better than he was before. Meanwhile, we are going to get the double kill. Kells, he's going. He's going to be burning up, but he's still chasing. He has that blink up. Can he go for the Phoenix? Oh, he's going back in. He goes in. He gives him the defusal. He followed your advice, man. He's got no mana. He's going to get slowed down. He can't do anything about this. And that Chemical Rage, only going to keep him alive for so long. He wants to continue to go forward. Jabs, he goes in once again. Another defusal charge burned down. And that's going to be a killing spree out for Lakels, splitting the wealth. And that's going to be only Faceless Void getting out alive. The good news,
disaster.
Though, he's got his chrono, man.
Well, you found something.
He's got his chrono.
I credit you. That's a 3k gold swing at the 16-minute mark. Not conducive to victory here. And they still have the Aegis on the Juggernaut. So they can just take that and start pressure. Like, you look at the net worth graph and you're like, oh, I mean, that's okay. Now the game's even. Yeah, well, they have an Alchemist. So I'm wiping like 6k off that right now.
Yeah, look at the overall XP. That's a little bit more telling as it just falls off a cliff.
Oh. Very difficult game right now.
Alright, deep rotation in. We've got Jabs. No Omni Slash from him, but he's just full on ready to go in. They get the Magic Missile here. Mana burning up every which way. Chakra's popping out. They bring in the Oracle. Nice heal. Shanice wants to go in and continue to pressure this. They bring in the Void, who's got the Chrono, keep in mind. Hey, look at that! They got the Vengeful Spirit!
Yeah, they block out the Jug. I mean, they have to get her, I suppose, because they'll just swap, right? So.
Aegis 2.
Could be dead? I don't think.
Yeah.
No TP.
Very dead. Meanwhile, there was a tower traded up top. Dire's able to go through and pick themselves off that top lane. So all the tier 1's now cleaned up. But it's.
That was a weird play.
That was definitely a very quirky fight.
Like, why are your Venge and Jug roaming through here without Omni Slash? There's just, like, no reason to do that. I don't know. I got nothing.
I'm curious about Void's build and how exactly it's going to scale up.
Well, basically, like, I've seen the AC he picked up first, I believe, it was like blink into an AC. So it is kind of weird. It's kind of like a mid, like, I'm a half carry kind of deal. I'm kind of like a half a core. So in this sense, he's going more towards that core kind of style, get the Mantis style, and maybe into Defusal Blade after that too. Pretty handy in a game like this. More attack speed as well, depending on how he wants to go. Even like Mantis style into AC would actually be kind of cool. But you start looking like this Animage Lakels, and how are they actually going to kill him? It'll have to be like Mega Farmed Alchemist, it seems.
Yeah, I mean, he himself is quite Mega Farmed. We are 18 minutes in, and he's almost got his freaking Mantis style on top of his Battle Fury and Vlad's and Treads.
And he's, 2100 behind the Alchemist. I think he'd be pretty happy with that.
Yeah.
Considering he's been pretty free. Put MTR. Wow, he is like at the exact same spot he was last time I looked, but pick up his Vit booster. trying to get himself towards that bloodstone slowly but surely.
He's got the bloodstone
recipe.
Needs
the recipe.
Yeah, on the courier. Yeah.
Oh, so he's done then. Okay, yeah. Well, that's good.
All
break
right.
Them booties.
Smoke in. Looks like we could have a rotation coming through as we are going to have our ancients taken out. Laquelle's no mercy. He takes what's his.
The raining gameplay, yeah, just keep smoking on Chrono. I like this. I like the fact they're being active, because if they're passive, I actually think they'll lose this game.
Oh, they go in. They will get the leap off. It looks like they should easily get the kill on the Vengeful Spirit. She's going to get saved up by the Dazzle, but that just means there's less Graves going on. As
that
we,
was good.
All right, we got that Chrono to hit the pause button on the fight. They should be able to go through. They get the Vengeful Spirit. They should get the Dazzle as well. Can they get the Bash? Lucky Bash, no.
Okay, that was a little bit unfortunate, honestly. But...
oh, Anti-Mage. Going in, they've dropped the Primal Roar onto the Oracle, and again, no anything to keep himself healthy. Another Grave comes out as Beastmaster's still up, still fighting. Laquelle's able to go through, get a double kill. Beastmaster's turning this one around.
Yeah,
lots of pings out. They aren't able to get down the Void.
Oh, that's frustrating. Like, I understand. I totally understand. And that was just attack rolls, right? That's all that came down to. If there was just like five more damage on that Venge, she just dies.
This is the second trade of the game where it's been everyone but the Void drops for the Vengeful Spirit. So, again, you're content to do that.
Yeah. I actually think they played it right in a lot of ways. Just slightly unlucky, slightly couldn't get, you know, like one last little bit. Just had to tap that Venge right as they dropped the Chrono. Because it looked like she was like at 1 HP and was about to die. And so you would have got the kill, and then you hop right on the Dazzle and immediately blow her up with all three heroes. Her, I'm not sure why. I just made Dazzle female. Sorry, Dazzle, but...
it's
I mean,
nice and
you're
pink.
Kind of purpley. Yeah, yeah, he's got some pretty wacky hair. Anyway, it's just like, I get it, but you don't blow up Dazzle, and then the rotations come through, and you're just totally screwed, so. It's been unlucky, unfortunate, but also just a better played game here by Signature Trust.
All right, Timbersaw kind of caught out unaware, but is able to differentiate himself away. And feels nice and safe. You've got the Dazzle now picking up that Solar Crest, and, you know, that's a pretty neat item for him. In terms of overall net worth, we are going to see it hitting zero, which, again, to nullify the Alchemist, that's like a 6,000 swing in favor of Sig. Overall experience is going to be about 7,500. Taking a look at our level chart, it's really starting to show. You've got, you know, your Dazzle now with this level 11. You've got Anti-Mage at level 17. The highest level on the Radiant is level 14 on the Void.
Yeah, this is some serious AM gaming.
Look at those last hits. He's almost like 100 last hits above the Void.
Yeah, he's farming surprisingly well in the Void, honestly. As a Phantom now too, but just getting quite a few last hits. And there's that Blink. So he actually stops, that's kind of funny, he stops at level 2. Like, most people will do like level 1 into the Blink, but he's decided that it's time to deal with this Alchemist. Jacko has Chrono.
Alright, they go down the Roar. DDZ going to be temporarily protected. It looks like the Chrono will come in. Does catch out too. They want to focus down the Beastmaster. He already popped his Roar, so not the most value kill they ever had. Now the Egg from the Phoenix is going to be going in. Can they get it down before it hatches? They will be able to do so. They got the Grave rocking onto the AM. Who's going to be jumping back. They will be able to go through and get the Omni. Unfortunately, Dazzle does drop. That's going to be Jabs. Oh my. Alright, Laquelle's. Can you book it out of here? He's got his Blink at the ready. Should be able to walk back safely. But anyway, I mean, I guess if you had to lose three heroes on the side of Sig Trust, those are the ones you can drop.
Yeah, it really is.
And they get the Alchemist in return.
They get a slight win, but not like Power Game. This isn't like that turnaround fight that they really need quite yet, but it's a start, for sure. If only there was a little bit more mana on that Alchemist, he could have had a concoction right on top of that egg, but thanks to the illusions, Laquelle's playing a very smart. And Jacko? Oh, he might actually be dead. He's going to go for this. It's a tough kill, though.
Yeah, I don't think they have the raw catch for that. There will be that little purge. Laquelle's able to blink it off.
Go buy his Basher now. Be like, God damn, if only I spent this stupid money. Would have been able to kill him.
I mean, yeah, there's the Basher.
Shit. Stupid courier. Who hit the courier? I had that kill. Game was over.
All right. Things are looking pretty nice. And up top, we could have some initiation here, but DDZ... doing alright. He's got himself like his base kit, but Anti-Mage being or surpassing the Alchemist on the chart at this point is really bad for Alk.
Oh yeah, that is very depressing. Where is, does he have anything on the courier? Any? No, he's got nothing, so. Still not well under his way to the Octarine Core. If he even goes for that, I don't know if it's really an Octarine Core. It kind of is, only because a lot of the heroes besides the Anti-Mage are kind of group up heroes, like Doug can split Persona Zone because he's got the Battle Fury, of course, but I'd still be okay with the Octarine Core, honestly. There's like sometimes in situations as an A or as an Alchemist, you have to like fight to turn the game around, and so you go for like an AC or something, but I'm not sure with the Void if you can do that.
Speaking of Void, he's going to be going for that Defusal next. He's got his Manta Lincolns online. He's hitting quite hard, but, you know, where does he really start to have that impact? Does he just have to land Chrono after Chrono? Because right now he's 5-0-4, which is fantastic, and he's holding on to third slot in the net worth. He's farming amazingly, but he just doesn't feel like a hard carry.
Manta Defusal is going to be really good. Like, he can blow up whoever doesn't get swapped or graved in the fight, but that's the problem, right? Like, they have swap and grave for the Chrono.
Alright, speaking nice of Chronos, quench. They are able to drop it down. No reaction there from the Dazzle. Can't get off that grave. Alright, I eat my words. He's feeling good.
That was so sick. Whoa, that blink was fast from AABBA. Holy shit. Did you see that? It was just like gone in a second.
He's like, I feel unsafe. Go away.
Oh man, that was nice. Fast fingers. That wasn't even like a double tap blink because he went on an angle. Damn, dude. Anyway, at least they might get Roshi. This would be huge for the Radiant side to deny this from the Dire. This is like a game-winning Roshi if the Dire take it.
Alright, well, they bring in Lakels here. He's going to get temporarily stuck in place. They don't have the Chronosphere for this. And the Egg coming down the swap away. Antimage just books it out of here. Knows he can't fight. Jabs is able to go through and get the Phoenix down. Jabs is still up and still fighting. There's going to be a leap up. Jacko stuck himself on the cliff. He wants to go TP out. They will be able to go in. Once again, the third time this game we've seen the trade. Four heroes except the Void. Go down and trade that for the Ventral Spirit.
Yeah, it's just good prioritization by Signature Trust, honestly. They're just like, alright, no Chrono. Ignore the Void. He does a decent amount of damage, but he doesn't have the best chase. Can't just like non-stop time walk, especially because he starts getting low on mana. And he's playing really safe. Like, that's why he's 7-0-4. He's not like total YOLOing in these fights. And at that point, I don't think he could have really done too much more heady YOLO, so. Gabby, gonna run into Jabs. That's depressing. This is like your big hero, you just like run away from this like lone juggernaut. Might think there are more there though.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Down bottom, we've got Lakel just split pushing up. He's got himself his full Vanguard now, so very close to that Abyssal Blade, and that's gonna be a huge component of lockdown. He's also got a second life there, courtesy of the Aegis, so we can afford to be a little bit more YOLO. Jacko is going to have that Chronosphere up in three. Maybe they look for some sort of big game-changing play here, but it feels like Power are starting to fall more and more behind. All right, Lakels, please have a little mercy.
I think he has no mercy.
I don't think so.
Oh, he's going to do it. Lakels. Oh, the time dilation. All right, nice. Okay.
Wow. He's now godlike. 9-1-8. This Antimage has come online. He has surpassed the Alchemist net worth by a fair margin. He is level 21. Compare that to the Alchemist level 15. It's feeling really good for the AM.
Man, this is so depressing. They like cannot kill him twice. There's just no way. Swap, grave. Look, he knows it.
Oh, the bashes. This dude's so much work.
Yeah, nice little Lincolns from Jacko for sure. Pretty good, tagging it on, but it does look like Caesar Trust may have secured this one.
I agree. I think so. We are going to have a nice Chrono in the back line. They are going to go on to the Beastmaster, but swap out Fei Mao playing this Venge up to the best of her ability, and it's certainly going to be enough. As Jabs could be in some trouble, they will end up losing their Juggernaut, but
they're still going to Supernova.
Lakels is in some trouble. Going to get healed up, graved up, blinks out. Spock may have given his life for this, will have given his life for this. There's a TP back in from the Timbersaw as they're looking perhaps for a little bit more chase, at least to clear out their lanes, but Sig Trust, they're feeling fantastic. They weren't actually able to go and crack any racks. They take out the tier 3 towers, but don't exactly keep their eyes on the prize. Instead, just try to farm up a couple heroes and lose their Juggernaut, which is never ideal.
Yeah, that was a send the Animage on the high ground in Siege moment. And like wait till they Chrono or do something, because there's no Blink Dagger on the Void, so there's no like he's gonna blink past the AM and Chrono all of you, right? There's just no way that place happens. So theoretically, they could have just had Lakels on the high ground, destroying buildings the entire time with Grave, Swap, and Mages.
Oh, well, they get the time dilation here. They're gonna get the purge off. Lakels in some trouble, is able to blink away to safety. That was a little bit too close for comfort. He's under attack.
Little Manta there, so it's fine.
Dark light.
What's the recovery play here? I mean, the Octarine Core, DZ, he's going for it. He's going to try and keep these lanes pushed out. Thankfully, they didn't lose the racks. That's a a little bit harder to keep that economy going for the Radiant side here, so they can be happy. That'll cost them a couple buybacks.
Yeah, it's...
Yeah, Lotus Orb for the Timber.
Alright.
Good item.
I like it.
Swap up with Chrono available. Try and save the game. So, let's see. He has the Chrono... Oh, man, this is depressing. Oh, the scan. They caught them, actually. They saw the rotation. The Radiant scanned the Dire. The Dire scanned the Radiant, that is. Jabs just runs into them anyway.
Okay, they get Jabs. He's going to be spinning up. There will be another great swap out. Ventral Spirit once again gives her life. It allows for an Omni Slash to go through. And that's going to be a reset there. Phoenix goes in the egg. Going to be immediately cleaned up. Jabs, he knows what he got to do, and he will be able to get it down. There will be a grave here. Jabs staying alive for now. I believe he ends up falling in the end, but no, going to be healed up by the Dazzle. They catch out Jacko. Oh gosh, this is terrible. They're looking for more here, as there is just going to be the Timbersaw trying to scurry away. Up top, we've got the Alchemist, but oh man, they just lay down the law. They get the Abyssal going, they get the Roar going down. That's going to be a very dead Timber. Once again, Venge for four, and it's working out.
Yep. Again, you understand why they're going out and they're trying to make these plays, but it was going to be difficult. And that Chrono was actually like as perfect as it could have been, realistically. Like, you had the Jug on the far side away from where you knew his supports would be. You're trying to create that gap from the swap and from the Grave, but Radiant we're just far enough in the game that the range of both of those spells is just massive. Like, Grave level 4 is huge. Swap, he's level, must be level 2 by now. Yeah, he's level 11, so it's all that matters. You can outrange the Chrono every single time.
Alright, backdoor protection doesn't mean anything against this much damage. The Aegis is consumed, so Lakels can't go full YOLO mode, but he does have that full set of racks going his way, and they are able to back off and reset and start pushing out top and do whatever they please.
And again, like, despite, look where that fight happened. It happened over here, but because of this lineup, they can just punish a ridiculous amount. So fast, taking these buildings thanks to Inner Beast. And Venjora, for that matter. Gotta love percent-based auras. Something else.
All right.
Me and the crew now pushing down mid, though. Wow, Hood of Defiance on the Dazzle, the Butterfly, and the AM. He is so unkillable right now, it's actually not even funny. It's just gonna be depressing.
Yeah, I mean, 12, 1, and 10, that one kill was fairly early on. And since then, he just hasn't given anything up. He's way beyond godlike. I mean, next up, what do you do? Like, upgrade your shoes? Like, what's there to do?
Pretty much it. Yeah, Moonshard and then booties. Give me booties first, probably. But he probably wants the attack speed just because he's so ham. He's just like, yeah, let's go. Let's just get a Moonshard, I'd say.
All right, Beastmaster now with the Boots of Travels as well. He's got himself his full kit. I mean, Blink, Necros, Force Staff, Gem of True Sight, and now Boots of Travel. This is huge. Now Blink
wow,
in.
The dream.
DDZ gonna stun up one of the illusions, and the real Anti-Mage is completely fine.
So I'm just push this lane. Everyone else is here. Beastmaster can just TP in 20 seconds while pushing the bottom lane by himself. This would be a great pick if they actually wanted to go for that, but it would also be pretty obvious thanks to this ward down bottom.
Hey, Mop Packs, you like stats, right?
Stats are pretty good.
Yeah, how many pings per minute have we seen this game? Like, on average?
Oh, I don't know. I would say probably, like, 9, maybe 8 per minute. Look at these. So many
no, it's
pings.
Way more than that. It's, like, 30 per
I was thinking there
minute.
Were, like, maybe lulls or something, but... Maybe there haven't been that many lulls. He just four-stepped the center. Did you see that?
Yeah. Oh, what is it? Some good old animal cruelty for you.
Yeah, that's just maximum efficiency. I'll get near my boars faster.
All right, Juggernaut, he's going to be saving himself a slot here. 4k golds on this little dude. Wow, he's hitting fast.
Ping, ping, ping. Yeah, that really has been the game, honestly.
Alright, well, this ping is important. They see the Anti-Mage there. Maybe they can all rotate in for him, but... Oh, he's gonna blink back to safety. They just can't focus him. He's gonna do Anti-Mage things.
Let me see here. So he has 2400 HP. What's his total magic resistance at this point? 62% XD, 62% physical damage reduction as well. So, if he is chronoed, could they kill him? Five here. They probably could with Void... Timber and Alchemist, if Alchemist can right click. I think those three heroes could kill him. I think. I'm not positive. And that's kind of sad. He almost has MKB, though. Almost being 3,000 gold away.
He's struggling. I mean, his Void did so phenomenally early game, but it's a faceless Void. You don't expect him to be able to hang on for dear life at the top of the net worth chart against this lineup.
Yeah, he needs a buddy. He doesn't have a buddy. It's all by his lonesome. His Alchemist has abandoned his team. He's just PvPing, killing creeps the entire game. He's got Shiva's Guard, okay. PvP is back.
It's just like, I feel like Power Gaming are getting led on a chase, like, all around the map, and Trust just go in, they clear a lane, they back off, and then Power Gaming react to that, like, 30 seconds later, and they're just always taking a couple of steps behind SigTrust. SigTrust are always leading the charge. Oh Lakels! That was a blink. That certainly was. They're going to be going in. They spray the time dilation. They find the real guy. He's got his blink back up. Can they actually lock him down here? He's going to be graved up on the back lines. We have that primal roar. They're going to get down the Phoenix here. Lakels is still up, still fighting. He will end up dropping down. That's a huge streak going to the Faceless Void. 1,300 gold going his way. They trade for a Phoenix, but that is still very beneficial for Power.
Yo, where was the swap, though? You have Aether Lens.
I don't think she was close enough.
Hey, now. Tisk, tisk. I mean, it was mostly just the blink. I'm not sure what happened there. Like, why did he blink down to the river? Not sure if he was worried they were there. But either way, great pickoff. I mean, that's the kind of stuff. Just do that, like, 10 more times. Bring this game back to even. And life will be good.
It's still a very long road. I feel like Alchemist has kind of missed his point of maximum efficiency in the game. Like, his point of Alchemist starts to have an impact here, but we'll see.
Yeah, there's like two Alchemist
back.
Strats. Oh, yeah.
Oracle, in some serious doo-doo. Does get a chance to react to that. They're gonna bring in DDZ, but DDZ now the focus has the BKB rolling, but oh golly, that's not good. As none of this is good. It looks like Feimao will eventually live, gets back to base alive. They do trade for the Dazzle, but DDZ is able to go and hop right into the Roshan pit. Now Faceless Void is going to be going in. He's got himself that Demon Edge like you were talking about. He has room for an extra life if he wants to grab it up, but I don't really know what the Aegis does for Power Gaming. Seems like SigTrust are, you know, they're fine without it. They'd like it, but it's not going to be game-owning for Power.
Radiant's middle tower. Doesn't seem that way. It's still like such a hard game to turn around. At least it is only one rack, so again, the constant split push from the Alchemist, it can kind of continue, but they have such good heroes dealing it, like the Beastmaster so far
back
at this
in.
Point.
They're able to swap back the Timber and cancel his TP.
That is kind of nice, actually. The aim will come in.
And TP to the Hawk. The Beastmaster comes in. There's the Lotus Horde. Vengeance of stunning herself. But, alright, Roars himself. So that's definitely the most utility Lotus Orb I've ever seen. But they're going to drop the Abyssal here, and they should be able to kill on Tempest Law.
Oh, now Phoenix too. Save your buddy syndrome. We've all had that.
Oh, yeah.
Free feed for nothing.
All right,
now that MKB is done, yeah. Ooh, okay, that's good. Eggs on Void, right?
We'll see. Who's getting the goodies? Yep, that's Void.
Sure. They need Chrono every time if they want to kill AM, so.
Alright, but there's going to be a four-man weave. This is going to be a very hard lamp to fight into. I think when next wave of creep waves comes, we'll see this tier 3 getting pushed.
Right now on the Timber. That's actually okay here, only because they're going to be using it from like the high ground position. You can like blink out, deal damage, and come back in. A little different cheeky plays you can do. Dire Sile just back themselves away, and man, they are still so rich. Like, they still have money to burn, really. Like, Jabs sells drums, he can pick up something, or he can go for the bots if he wanted. Honestly, like, selling his drums for a blink could kind of be the play.
I mean, selling his drums for, like, a butterfly could be a play, too.
Yeah, that too, if he just wants to, like, full physical. And that was kind of the issue in the bottom fight. Like, the first time when they didn't get the racks, it was the jug actually went in, like, too deep. They didn't like actually just focus buildings and all that other stuff, so not sure if maybe the blink might add into that syndrome. I'm not too sure, but it would help for like the chrono and dodging that out. We've already seen AABBA dodge it out a couple times, so wouldn't mind seeing a secondary blink here. And, oh, that's the real Void. Back himself up. So look at the caution though. Much more patient right here from Signature Trust. They're not just running down every single lane by themselves.
Oh, sorry, I'm a little out of it. My back is killing me. I slept, like, twisted to the side, so I'm like...
Are you, like, on the pullout?
What?
Are you like on like a, do you have to like rock the pullout couch or anything?
No.
That's the worst for me.
No,
that's
I got good. Twin mattress on the floor. That's
nice.
Fun.
Nice, good.
No, I slept like super bad. I had like a pillow wedged under me, so it's all like, oh, I can feel like a crick. I'm gonna go like pop some crazy Advil after this game.
Nice, nice. I mean, we gotta see what looks like will be Power Gaming again here, but you never know. If you guys tuning in here, this is our winner bracket. So, loser of this goes down the lower bracket and they play right again. So maybe, hopefully, you know, don't feel too tilted if they lose this series. Honestly, either team losing this might be a little bit tilted just because Power Gaming having that first pretty solid game number one.
Yeah, that was definitely something to watch. Not quite sure how much of that was Drow Strat from Sig Trust not performing, but oh, scan up top. Feels the Beastmaster's chilling. Very nice scan. Not something I would have expected.
Yeah, it kind of comes at a waste, though. Like, what's the point? I feel like it was like an argument. And they're like, yo, no, he's just sitting up here. He's going to push the lane again. Okay. No, no, he is. I don't think he is. Scan. Ha, see, he's there. All right. Like, what are we going to do about it? It just can't even capitalize on it.
That's true. All right.
Poor staff for the dazzle.
I mean, overall net worth is evening out. It's pretty in favor of Sig Trust still. Again, a big portion of Power Gaming's net worth is on the Alchemist, so you nullify what the Alchemist brings to the fight, it's going to be, you know, at least a 12,000 gold advantage, but overall XP is still looking really, really strong. Almost 20,000 for Sig. Their levels are phenomenal, but can they keep this up? I mean, they've got Jug almost level 25, Anti-Mage is 25. The next highest hero on the Radiant is 21 on the Void. I mean, there's such a huge advantage for Sig Trust, but they can't actually go through and get another lane of Rax. They're just really struggling to rip off the Band-Aid and get this done.
Yeah, I think they're a little bit worried just because of what happened to Lakels. They're just like, you know what would be great? An Aegis on our Anti-Mage. And he's like, well, unfortunately, I can't get one, so I'll buy a Heart. I think that kind of makes sense. They don't really need more damage, right? It's just about him surviving and living. But he'll view that as more
Dire's
valuable. And what did, what did he... Oh, the Vlads, right? Okay, that's it. That's fine.
All right, smoke gank gone through.
Nice bounty rune at 41 minutes for an alchemist.
You know, that's always worth.
How much was that? Was that like 700 gold?
Probably. Chug with the MKBs. All right, they're jumping in. They want to get something done here. They do get the roar onto Jacko. Remember that he's got his Lotus Orb, but it's not going to make a difference to go in immediately. Phoenix Egg. This could be it here. Switching over to buybacks. It's not looking great. Phoenix doesn't have one. Void does. May have to buy back into this. And I've got the Alchemist, but again, the Chrono is the huge setup for these fights.
So he buys back. No Phoenix Egg, but they still have the Timber Saw, so relatively okay. Honestly, the Phoenix Egg's getting blown up anyway, so just like more of a taunt.
Alright, so stun comes out, Lakel's able to mantle that off, and DDZ just left to clean up the illusions. The tower's taken some serious push damage, and Creep Wave comes in. I mean, this could be a reinitiation point from Sig Trust, but they're gonna back off, they're gonna play this one safe. Hopefully we get to see some raw action soon, some team fights or whatnot, but...
And they're weaving up, I think they want to go, like, it's still so long before Roche. I'd be surprised if they backed away. See why. Very patient. Can't quite get the Hawk.
Radiant's top tower.
This is that slow siege that we kind of want. Like, this is the positioning we were looking for before, right? Like, look at this. This is a very, very nice by Signature Trust.
Yeah, they go in and they're bringing the Juggernaut to the top lane, getting that chip damage down. Finally, able to go through, cleanse this tier 3 of its existence. And they're looking for more. We still got Juggernaut doing his thing. We'll get a plop down by Oracle, but he'll be okay.
Interesting. They're, like, begging them to... Chrono Lakels, or sorry, Jabs. Like, leaving him alone solo, but the only way they can kill him is gonna be through a Chrono, and then if you don't Chrono Lakels, you'll never kill him, so... Hold on.
Lakels? Alright, he goes in a bit ambitious there, takes a very short-range concoction, he goes in, mantas off, and now he got his eyes on the prize. Look at the damage he's doing to this Rax. There's nothing Radiant can do about it. On the backlands, you've got Juggernaut still exerting the pressure. Jacko, he's holding onto that Chrono for all it's worth. They are gonna bring in another Unstable Concoction, channeling it up. They're looking for more. It will connect onto Lakels. But he's gonna be fine. I mean, he's just so tanky. He's got himself a heart.
Oh, there's the Chrono. They actually did it. So look at the kill in the Jug, but this means Lakels is pretty firm. And he might bots back in. Oh, he doesn't have bots. I mean, he gets buyback bots.
Abba, though, that's he's gonna be in some trouble. Has that roar if he wants to turn around and shout, but...
Double four staff, nice.
Oh.
Going back in?
Oh, man. Yeah, that seemed like a pretty ambitious reinitiation. Now, Lakel's actually may have bitten off more than he can chew. There is a grave at the ready. They are going to bring in jabs as well. Okay, that's a BKB Juggernaut soaring in. There's a roar connecting onto two DDZ. It's going to be sitting there, just has to take the damage, will go down, has the buyback, immediately spends it. But that's the Timbersaw going down, no buyback from him. And this could be GG as the mid laner Rax will fall up top. They can go and easily crack that last set. That's going to be most likely Megas pretty soon. The final Fortify is dropped. They're going to be focusing down some damage here. It's going to be a four step out. DDZ, oh, going to get Omni slashed up. Tries to Manta it off. Will it be successful? This will be a dieback from the Alchemist. He's still alive for now. Faceless Void doesn't have that chrono up for another second. Now it's up. Can he actually get the chrono of his lifetime, or will his team get mega creeped?
Chrono.
YOLO chrono, man.
Radiant's top that's GG. Has
I think so.
They want to try and hold out. Oh, they're going to make them earn it. Make them work for it. I mean, they don't even have a tier 2. It's a very difficult game to come back from Mega Creeps.
I mean, Alchemist can push pretty quickly, like Timber kind of, but everyone else from that just kind of one hit right clicks them, and it's going to take so long to clear out these creep waves, and you really can't do that up against an anti-mage that wants to just eat your face off at every point in the game. So anti-mage eats up a moon shard. He's still got 5k gold to his name.
If only he could buy some Agnes Scepters. He just loves his attack speed so much. This guy, you know, Lakel's loves farming. He's like, nah, I don't want bots. Ben A. Oh, yeah, Beastmaster Refresher. Okay. For a second, I thought it was AM's. I'm not sure why, but.
AM I mean, Refresher, so rich, man. But... You gotta, like, triple blink out of there.
Good. No BKB, though. Wasn't necessary this game, so Refresher pretty trash for him, but always good on Beastmaster. I love Refresher Beastmaster. It's like
Alchemist.
The only item for me.
Alchemist buys out there again. He did buy back in that last fight, so he goes for the Aghanim Scepter, as well as his own Monkey King bar. And Ag Synth is gonna be going onto that Timbersaw.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, they got double Chakrams now.
More damage. What's his Bloodstone at, though? 4. Like, he doesn't even have the mana to use this. That's slow at regens. It's only 18. Bad life.
Alright, overall net worth now going to be about 20,000 in favor of Sig. Overall experience, similar story. They get themselves an Aegis, they put it on the Juggernaut, so he's able to dive deep and force those split initiations like last time.
Alright, they going in. They doing it. Lakel's Dota. He's waiting for this Alk. Got the Abyssal. Does he go? He's just total BM here. He's waiting for his team.
I mean,
like
if they get
boy.
The Alchemist down, I think it's GG.
He just doesn't want to get chronoed with no supports nearby, though. It's the only risk for Lakel's. They want the 5-man weave again. All right, put this one to bed, boys.
Yeah, I'm a little bit ready to get on to our next series. It's been an amazing game to watch, but ultra long games like this, it's unfortunate. Like, if there were turnaround potential, it'd be interesting, but at this point, it's just kind of like everyone getting swapped around, played with. Nice Phoenix Egg. It's going to do a lot of work. Lakel's actually in some trouble here. He doesn't have a second life. If he goes down here, that's going to be huge. He's going to get graved up. There's a roar. Connects onto Jacko. They should be able to turn this and get down the Faceless Void. He already popped his chrono. No jabs. He's got the Aegis, remember, so it's not detrimental that he goes down here. An Alchemist may end up stunning himself. That's going to be a leap in. Meanwhile, Jacko's able to get a double kill. Does take out Dazzle on the back line.
Lakel's? He's in the fountain? Did
you not? Lakel's? Lakel's? Why?
I mean, he has buyback and he has bots.
But why?
I don't know. He was trying to chase the Oracle. They're just clowning. They're like counter clowning. It's kind of clowning the power even still in this, honestly. And like not GGing. XD. What more is there to say? Look at these pings.
We just gotta keep pinging, man.
Man, seems to just love their pings. I like hope that they win this simply because it'll save my eardrums in the next series.
Yeah.
Alright, there's the AC. Yeehaw. Some minus armor. Gonna try and deal with these weaves. Oh wow, Alka actually is 0-7. Poor guy. Sorry, DDC. 17 assists.
I mean, he's got,
though,
yeah,
that
he's
acid
got some
spray.
Decent assists. So
Void's a kill stealer. Actually, it's probably the Oracle. I only stole 2.
It's just not a lot of kills in general. 22 to 40, starting to look pretty tough.
Maelstrom. Gotta deal with these mega creeps. Gonna have a Mjolnir that I swap out in the base.
Oh man.
Dota 2.
It's a game. Alright, so we'll see what's going down here. Is Alk, I mean, he's farming up a storm. He's built enough ags for his whole team, but is there any comeback potential off of that?
Sure. No, there's not, but you know, sure. Why not? I mean, let's say, theoretically, if Signature Trust get frustrated and they double buyback on Jug and AM and they TP back into the base and somehow die, like a surprise refresher from Faceless Void or something, they could lose the game. It is actually still possible.
Alright, so Juggernaut now has an Abyssal as well.
Yeah, he just straight bought it.
For some reason, I thought that was Anti-Mage buying a second Abyssal, and I got very confused. No, Time Dilation here. Okay, Veimao really out of position. Just gets plummeted down, and there's no buyback on that Venge.
Yeah, bail those creeps, Fly Solo. Get him. Teach him who's boss.
Meanwhile, Laquelle's just three-hitting an entire camp. He's got himself 5,000 golds on top of... I mean, what does he buy here?
I mean, bots too. Duh.
Yeah.
Gotta have that glorious secondary TP.
He could eventually sell Manta if he really needed to, or Battle Fury, but... Alright, down bottom. Beastmaster's got that roar. He's bringing in his army. Got those little Necro units up and ready to run and just easily taking down this wave.
Man, if only Alchemist could hand out Maelstroms, they can hand out Aghanims.
If only Alchemist could just share all of his items.
And maybe if Alchemist consumes the Aghanims, like for himself, rather than just getting stats, he should be able to give any item to anyone.
It's not overpowered.
He just starts handing out everything.
You know what? We should make like a custom game called Communism, where you can just give your items to other people and you all share the wealth.
That sounds good, actually. Like, no, gold is just a giant shared pool.
Yeah, like Heroes of the Storm. Except there's no items in Heroes of the Storm.
Oh, there you go.
Alright.
No items. Oh, and Monkey King Bar.
We got MKBs every which way. Got 3 MKBs in the pool now. Oh, 4. Void has his own.
4 MKBs. That's a lot of monkeys.
So many Monkey Kings. Who's the rightful king? Alright. Walking in, we got the smoke gate coming out. Sig Trust. Might be looking to end this once and for all.
Generally, the other team has 4 boots of travels. Generally, you know, on her, the Vengeful Spirit, problems might be being had. Where's that? My Aghanim Scepter on my Venge, by the way. Come on now.
No, I gotta get this boots of travel.
Like, really?
That was a buyback boots of travel, I believe. Alright, Jacko gonna get his Lincoln's pop. They're gonna bring in Laquelle's, unleashing the damage. Can they keep him locked down for long enough? He's gonna be going. He wants to get that Chrono off. He's able to turn. He's able to get the Chrono. 3 are connecting. The Phoenix Egg is gonna hatch. That's gonna be a huge amount of lockdown. They get down Laquelle's. He has buyback, but that's gonna be huge. Jabs once again held in place. He himself does not have that Aegis anymore. He's gotta be very, very careful. Meanwhile, on the tier 4s, Abba got his eyes on the prize. Able to go through, hatch down 1 with the help of those Mega Creeps. And is gonna force back DDZ to go and stun himself in the face. We are going to see Beastmaster just being a sneak there, but it cost them the Anti-Mage's life. I don't know if that's necessarily worth it.
That's all. I mean, Chrono for AM's life, I'll take that. Pretty happy. Happening, Annie. What is going on? How are you? What's going on, Annie? How's life?
I'm kind of tired.
Let's have a chat. That's good. You're tired, are you? You've been getting up early, 5 a.m. You've been staying up all night watching Summit, or rather Star Ladder anyway?
Oh, yes. Star Ladder, Netflix, good old mix of
Netflix?
The two.
Netflix? What are you Netflixing?
I just started Silicon Valley on HBO.
Oh, I've heard that's good.
And then
good.
I got my New Girl marathon going.
Oh, yeah?
Are you a New Girl fan?
No, I don't even know what it is. Never heard of it.
Oh, you know, I always pictured you as the chick flick type.
Oh, I mean, I love a good romantic comedy, don't get me
wrong. Oh, it's adorable. There's this quirky girl that moves to a new apartment with a bunch of guys, and she's, like, looking for love. I don't know, it's funny.
She's looking for love in all the wrong places or the right places?
I mean, it's just funny.
That's a very important distinction.
You know, we'll marathon it when we're in Seattle together. All right.
Sounds good.
No, tower taken down. I mean, are Power Gaming doing this? Is that what's happening
right now?
I mean,
right first tier two. Like, it's happening. Do I have to get, like, serious now that they've actually taken the tier 2? I mean, this would be, like, of the ages a comeback. I don't understand how Faceless Void's net worth is still so high. It's actually incredible. I mean, he keeps getting all the kills. Oh no, their courier. Nice one, AABBA. Did he roar it? Yeah, he totally did, didn't he?
Probably.
Yeah, they roared the courier or a Timbersaw.
Well, someone got roared. We should probably pay better attention, shouldn't we?
I don't think anyone would blame us.
All right, 60 minutes now on our third game of the day. We potentially have three more to go. I'm going to look for a more comfortable chair for series number two, but...
Gekko's surprisingly still not having a maelstrom, so he's still like really slow at pushing the waves. But he can't quite afford it. Like, he still wants boots of travel as he's just purchased those up and he still needs
to buy. Oh, we got a chrono. That's going to be huge now. We should be able to get down the Vengeful Spear, but it's going to be perhaps a swap in if she really wants to save herself. The grave is going to end. She goes for the stun. She goes for the mech. She's still alive. There's a leap in. She goes the four staff. They will pop a defusal charge on her. That's going to be Faceless Void occupied, though. The ancient is getting hit. Lakels cannot afford to go down here. He's going to try to blink himself away into the creeps. He's going to get stunned up. Oh, Lakels, please just hit the ancient. He's going to be alive for now. But the rest of the
gems. He's dead. He is so dead.
He's alive for now. No, he's dead. His corpse pops out of the Omni Slash. So. Juggernaut's dead, he's got himself 5 back. Anti-Mage had to leap away. Beastmaster barely gets out of there alive. And the Ancient is exposed. So small steps, baby steps, we're going forward. But look at the net worth. It's going back to zero.
What happened?
I don't know.
Did plug in their keyboards? Was something wrong?
I don't know. Like, it's all of a sudden, like, Power Gaming just woke up. Which I could really use if they've got some of that coffee to share.
I mean, a massive comeback will wake you up. I mean, this could turn into like a base race situation. There's so many boots of travel. It's like, that's what makes this comeback just so, so ridiculously hard for Power. Like, he has to, they have to somehow not only push out so far into the enemy base and not get backdoored at the same time by an Animage, Juggernaut, Beastmaster, Venge, Dazzle. Like, this Venge Beastmaster could like throne it while the Juggernaut and the aim aren't even there.
Yep.
Oh, Beastmaster? That was spooky. He just boots a travel to his boar and he might die.
He's okay.
Gekko, this is worth a chrono.
He's okay. He's double now damage he's too, so we could totally get it. Oh, the refresher popped out as well! Oh no.
Still has some wasted to buyback though. That's good.
Oh, and there's boots of travel down bottom. Lakels forcing out some rotations. Buyback from the Alchemist Forest. That's actually really expensive.
Yeah, unfortunately, it wasn't even going to be worth it. I think AIM had already backed off. Now that's going to like kind of pressure Power to possibly make a mistake. Because, oh, actually, there is a Roche coming up. They could go for that. Yeah, and they will. So that's going to be good, actually. That would have been really bad if there wasn't.
Radiant are doing it. Look at that net worth chart. It's touching zero.
It's still so difficult because the actual like objective positions, though.
No, they got this. All they need is wipes.
they got it. It's over.
It's over.
Call it.
Dude, I can't.
Top left, Sig. There's a little arrow. Go click it. Get the hell out of our game. We'll see you in a minute.
You know, I promise not to report.
Jacko's going back in. Oh, no.
Oh, Jacko. Okay, Lakel is actually going to be the one in trouble. Got to pop the chrono for this. They've got the burn coming out. Lakel's. Oh, he totally cannot afford this. The swap back out. Fei Mao saving his life for now. Goes in with the Ghost Scepter. They're going to be looking for more. Fei Mao going to get bashed up into the pit. Phoenix.
He broke. She killed him. The 58-minute Roche kill.
All right.
God damn it! Does that mean Roche gets the aura? No, he doesn't. That's depressing. Oh god, that's where you need that Aghanim Scepter. I guess actually, would Venge's eggs? Because Roche would instantly purge the illusion, right? Oh,
well,
that's
if,
so funny.
If the illusion
actually
attacked him,
or if he was aggroed. Or yeah, you're right. If he,
I mean, the illusion can
still
tank Roche.
I assume because like you killed, yeah, exactly. But if you like killed Roche and you're suddenly back, are you still like
attacking him? I don't think so, unless you have like auto attack on. Which well, I mean, all of these professional players probably do not. Just going out
some
of them.
Some do for like juking and fog and stuff. I usually have a toggle key. I'm not that. I don't have a toggle key.
Well,
ever since Source 2, I just got too lazy to redo them all.
Yeah, I have like my key bindings on, but like I just have like runes and Roche Pit bound to stuff, but I never remember what the bindings are.
All right, he's got a Mjolnir now on Jacko, thanks to those couple kills and whatnot. 16, 2, and 10 now. Getting rich. So who has buyback on the Radiant? Faces Void has... Wait, what? Oh, wow. He is... Man, that's an expensive buyback. Holy. 1930, so he just doesn't quite have it. He's about 60 gold short. Alchemist, 4 minutes to go, but... Oh, I gotta sort it by team. That is so much more easier.
Yeah, like the red with the yeah. Yes, no. Oh, God.
It's blowing my brain right now.
I can't. So
Timber, Oracle, Alch. And no Beastmaster buyback. That could be troublesome, but...
We got Radiant Turtling, we got Dire ready to go in for that final push. You got Vengeful Spirit with a big girl smoke. Invis Rune as well picked up by the Juggernaut. And then they're smoking on top of that, so Juggernaut can go in pretty deep here, won't reveal to anything. We'll see. Let's go. Come on, buddy. Let's get it done. They've got Beastmaster Refresher back online, so they've got two Roars if they need it.
Da-da, 60 minutes, smoked up Dark Side. Who's gonna goof? Who's pinging?
It's Radiant.
That's Radiant pings, they know. Oh, they destroyed the... Yeah, they had a ward over the Necros, so... They're fully aware of what's happening. The Weave, the Blinken, the Scythe from the Beastmaster. This could be the big play, but they gotta pop that Lincoln's first.
Oh, they're gonna be TPing someone in. Anti-Mage joins the party. They wanna go probably just straight for the throne. They don't wanna deal with anything. There will be the Faceless Void going in. Alright, yep, they're going straight in. They bring in the Necro units, they bring in the Anti-Mage illusions.
Getting saved.
Oh, there's one Roar. Abba in some trouble. It's just going to get immediately cleaned up. Vengeful Spirit with a swap back so they can get off another Roar if they need
that's
to.
That's refresh too.
Oh man, the Ancient, it's getting low, but Lakels, he's going down. Lakels is down. He has buyback if needed. He's going to hold on to it for now. Meanwhile, Abba in some trouble getting four-staffed away. They've got Timbersaw chasing him down. They get the Hex off because Beastmaster has a Hex. And I just... all right. Once again, stalled out fight.
They did it. They're holding. All right. I believe... the best part about Signature Trust so far through all of this and how unbelievably frustrating it is. This is like versus a like Kunkka Rapier or a Medusa Rapier. It kind of feels the same way because of just like the way this Chrono is, this Face of Void is so farmed with this Chronos and the Aghanim Scepter and the Alchemist, of course, who can just infinitely like push out these waves. It's the fact that they're not making the mistake of the panic buyback. Like, AM didn't just buyback and boss back.
Oh,
that
the
fight,
Roar.
That's how you lose.
Abba was still hiding out here. They're going to be flying in some buddies, but I think this is a very, very dead Beastmaster, and that is really unfortunate. 100 seconds, no buyback. Somehow, some way, Power Gaming are making space for themselves along this map. They're Ancient. It cut down to, like, half health, but it's now going to be regenning back up slowly but surely. You've got Jacko still keeping himself worthwhile in terms of net worth, surpassing the Alchemist now. This Void is like stupid farmed.
They might get mid-racks here, actually.
They can definitely.
Juggernaut's doing is this is a really good play by Jabs. This is the kind of stuff that can save you mid-racks. It's just cutting out these side lanes and pressuring Alf to continue pushing them. So he has bots too, and they'll be up in about 15 seconds. But I don't think you want to bots into this. Like, Faces Void can bots out, and he can be the one to go home and defend, but it's so scary to have the Alchemist, like, come into that situation to try and help him to push, so they might just let Alch go back home, and everyone else will push mid. But Jabs, making all the right moves right now. This is so smart.
Meanwhile, in Dire's base, we've got the Fortify being used, and they should be able to get a tower here. They're going to be using those little illusions, Manta on Manta fighting here, but in the end, the Tier 3 is cracked all of a sudden. Power Gaming are able to penetrate high ground.
Alright, don't take the risk though, they don't bring in the Alchemist. So, they're not gonna go. That's all because of this split push by the Jug, honestly. I think they could have taken Rax if he hadn't done that. So, really well played by Jabs. Good late game decision making. Honestly, all their late game decision making has actually been very good by Signature Trust. Except for the actual in-fight base. Like, the actual fights in here have been kind of shit. But other than that,
tell us how you really feel, Modpacks.
The lack of buybacks, like, they're not doing stupid buybacks in so many games. I can't tell you the number of games. Like, it's got to be over 100 where I have seen teams just totally goof and do one bad buyback and you just lose in a situation where if you were just patient, you would have eventually won the game. So, things to trust are impressing me in that sense, for sure.
All right. We've got more farm, Aegis Reclaimed, Roshan coming up in 5 minutes, so longer spawn this time. Almost max spawn, actually. That is
Roche
max spawn.
Roche is tired of this shit, yeah. Too. That's what it is.
I mean, after he got that kill on Venge, Roche is just taking a nap.
Jacko dead?
I believe,
I
yes.
He was,
I think he's
wow.
So much dead.
He's mega dead. That's
There's,
an omnislash.
Like, this is the most All dead right. I've ever seen a Void be.
I delivered
Into the void. Death.
Hey, Lamau. All right.
He'll have to buy back.
Yeah. He's got it, though. He's got buyback. He doesn't have, or rather, he will have Corona when he respawns, so that's going to be pretty important for his team. And you've got that smoked up Timbersaw looking to make the plays here.
Can you egg on top of the throne? You can, right? It's like Visage Verse sitting inside and you can't right click it.
Oh, okay. They got anyway. The swap back. They get the hex onto DZ. That's going to be huge. He's able to go in. He's going to be bringing in his teammates. Fei Mao might fall immediately. We'll get picked off. That's going to be a Corona coming out. No one inside the Corona, but still a nice zoning tool. They are able to go through Abyssal onto DZ. He's going to be in some serious trouble here. Healed up by the Oracle. Lacalus, he's running around. He's trying to just juke this out. He knows he can't stand up to this damage. This could be detrimental. He still has buyback if absolutely necessary. He's going to get healed up by the Dazzle. Shallow Grave coming in, but will expire. He's able to blink back to the low ground, back to safety. Chase in from the Timbersaw. Spock looks to be doing something. Meanwhile, the Ancient.
Bashes.
Oh my gosh. Oh, is this really
maybe
the end?
It's just down here, like, guys.
Oh, my gosh. Hey, Lakels, he's gone back on in. Everyone's running every which way. The Juggernaut is dead. That's a huge component of damage. They're going to bring in Lakels here.
Oh, he bought back. This could be it. These are the questionable buybacks. It's a Bloodthorn.
This isn't questionable. They're coming back in. Fly solo. He's living up to his name here, as he's the only one left in the low ground.
I see my back without Venge. No, alright, they're trying to pressure without Chrono, but there's only 8 more seconds. They have Chrono again. Oh, no. Questionable buybacks. Questionable buybacks, Annie.
Mop-packs.
I don't like it.
Are you okay?
I don't like it.
You sound frightened.
I am frightened. This is scary. Oh, God, that's the worst. Oh, this is exactly what you can't do. Like, they get nothing out of this.
No, they're going to get something.
Like, all they can do is possibly keep applying pressure, bring in the Venge, and... All right, here we go.
All right, so Juggernaut, he ain't got no buyback. Beastmaster, oh, he ain't got no buyback.
Oh, is this isn't back yet?
Juggernaut has this thing, Bloodthorn.
Yeah, he bought a Bloodthorn. Like, he bought back and bought Bloodthorn. He's like, yo, let's go. I got this. Bring it in the smoke.
I mean,
on
I think
the
that's
courier.
Just saying, like, Void, fight me, I dare you.
Well, he needs, it's probably honestly so we can just pop that damn Lincoln's and he's like, well, I have enough gold. I'll just make a Bloodthorn. And then I'm going to Abyssal you. And the cooldown's really short on Bloodthorn. It's only 11 seconds. So you can actually, like, pop Lincoln's, use your Abyssal, and then. Well, hopefully kill him, and then use your Bloodthorn like the next hero. Oh my god. Darth Katu.
Defense of the Ancients. I mean, it's working out. Power Gaming living up to the objective. They lost all their buildings, but this Ancient is thoroughly defended.
Quite defended, in fact. And look at it. It's almost back up to full. It's so close. Oh, it's going to be a 5, 4, 3, 2, what? Oh, there's 100 more to go. Okay. Reading is very
Roar.
Different. It's early in the morning, guys.
Timbersaw doing some chakram work.
Yeah, take that mana burn.
Alright.
Alright, 50 more to go.
Alright, let's keep our second counter going on. Gotta keep those cooldowns going. Rush on! Gonna be up in like 3 minutes. That's something both teams could look to take.
Alright, you ready? Are you watching the throne?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Like New Year's Eve. And it's full again!
Oh.
Wow. That was an exciting moment. That was like the best part of my day.
Wow.
That was the most intense thing to happen in the past like 15 minutes. No, I'm just kidding. It's actually been some pretty crazy fights. Buyback status again. Oh my god, that's scary. Dazzle. Animage. Timbersaw. Three heroes in the game with buyback. Oh god. Oh, scary, scary,
I mean,
scary.
Venge will have it. It's only like 200 more gold off for her, but...
And this max time Roche is huge. Like, imagine if Roche was up right now. That would be, like, so important.
Alright, so we got Anti-Mage sitting back. He's still got his Manta. Is this time where we sell this for Rapira? Is this what we're looking for? Okay, we're going in. This could be the end of here.
Jacko.
We got Jacko gun up. Lotus Orb looking down to stun himself. There is going to be the Phoenix Egg. They're looking to focus that instead. They're going to be going in. They should be able to take out the egg. They're going to zone.
They can't get him.
They can't get the egg. This is going to be huge.
Inside.
Abba, he's going to be stuck here. He does go down. There's going to be a Chrono here. Fei Mao drops as well. There's two dead. None of them a buyback. This could be Power Gaming coming right back in this. Meanwhile, the creeps, they're on the throne. They're going to be purged off right there. Throne. Oh, it's got a little bit of ways to go before it's full health. You get your favorite moment relived, man.
They crumbled.
Alright, let's watch the throne. It's going back up.
Oh, is it? Is
yep.
it? Oh,
ready?
This is really good. This is going to happen again.
Oh, it's almost
wow.
there.
That's how little damage they did to the throne. Oh, that's nice.
Alright, back to farming.
Remember all this impatience and no buybacks? Like, that was not waiting for Roche. Like, I mean, that's not play. There was definitely a wait for a Roche moment here. But unfortunately, the Dire not doing so. They get punished extremely heavily. Sick Aghanims, though, by the Phoenix. That was something that first time I think that we've seen the save, right?
What is
coming in there?
Antimage sold something to buy AC. Was that Battle Fury or something else?
He doesn't have Battle Fury, so yeah, I think that's what it was.
I don't know if he sold Battle Fury before or not. Alright, Dazzle scanned out, walking into the pit. Radiant, they could get a really free pick here. If Dazzle goes down, they suddenly lose all their teamfight control.
They're gonna think they're all inside, though. He might, like, blink Chrono and, like, screw everything.
Oh, see? You can feel that little shoulder tense. Oh, so Very. Exciting.
Wish fulfilled.
Oh, man. The bottom lane, these illusions still going. Pirate Gate, what are we at now? Still Timber, Dazzle.
Wait, we're so close to 71 minutes. That's where the map starts breaking. We got no Darkseers, but I'm still excited.
Yeah, I was going to say, there's no Darkseer, though. Like, Phoenix looks like a hero that would probably break.
Phoenix actually doesn't break as much as Anti-Mage does. Speaking of Anti-Mage, Oracle just gets knocked the frick out. All right, we got gems on the ground.
Ben just like, I have a slot, but I don't want it.
That is the lowest on the priority list. Phoenix finally picked off. Let's see if the map starts crumbling here as we are going to be approaching death territory, but we've got a Hex coming out. There will be stuns onto Dismount Illusions as we've got a Beastmaster creeping, crawling around. They're looking for something else.
All right, so this could be it, right? Like, no big save on the egg this time. This is all on Jacko. But in that sense, then, it's all going to be on these supports. Can't get Chrono next to the AM.
Radiant's Ancient is under attack.
And they're going on the Ancient here. We've got that Primal Roar coming back in. There's going to be a secondary Roar if they can get enough ammo, though. He's going to be stunned up, going to get Grave, though. Can he actually turn and get this off a second time? He's still got the Refresher. The Chrono. It's going to catch out all the big players. You've got Dabs who walks into the Chrono, but they're looking the Ancient. It's going to be going down. There's nothing they can do about this. Should be the end of the game. It's going to be Sig Trust finally taking this after 72 minutes of hard-fought action. The game is finally over, Mott Packs. What are your Woo! Final thoughts?
I think I've said enough.
It is done. Unbelievable hold by Power Gaming, honestly. Like, that's very impressive. You gotta hand them that. Lasted a really long time. Great patience for the vast majority of that game from Signature Trust. Very impressive late-game decision-making for a team that... Like, that's something that we always talk about when it comes to, like, those big LAN finals and those big, like... just some of the more even experienced teams will run into issues where they don't have a lot of experience with that. But I'm very impressed by the way they handled that entire last 40 minutes. Seriously, it's hard to see it if you don't watch a lot of Dota games. For like anyone there is like not like really paying attention to a lot of these games, but that is actually massive how patient they were.
All right, so we are going to be moving on. Sig Trust eventually take a 2-1 in this series, and that means next up we are going to have Power Gaming versus Mongols. What are you looking forward to there?
Probably, honestly, Mongols should have that series, I would think. I think they're probably the more, like, they've been playing very well lately, but Power Gaming showed a lot of, like, flashes of brilliance today, so I wouldn't be surprised if they took it, but I'm kind of expecting either a 2-0 or a 2-1 Mongols.
All right, so we will have to see here. Again, this has been the English Moon Duck coverage of Mr. Cat. Advancing in the upper bracket will be Signature. Dropping down, Power Gaming have one last shot to stay in the tournament, going up against Mongols in a best of three in just a couple of minutes. Should be up really, really soon, as we are already beyond the start time courtesy of Hour and a Half Games. So stick around. We will see you guys very shortly.